In this video, we will focus on the factors that affect the central venous pressure. There are four factors for us to discuss: the skeletal muscle pump, the respiratory pump, blood volume, and venomotor tone. Let's work our way through each one of these, beginning with the skeletal muscle pump. Okay, so when we deal with the skeletal muscle pump, you need to remember that veins outside the thoracic cavity have valves. What we are going to do is focus on the venous valves, specifically the distal and proximal valves, and just in one location, in the calf muscle. Keep in mind that distal means further away from the heart, and proximal means closer to the heart. Here we have a woman that is standing on her tippy toes. To be able to do that, her calves have to contract, which causes the distal valve to close and the proximal valve to open. Why did the proximal valve open? Since these are one-way valves, the blood in the vein was pushed upward, which pushed the valve open. All right, so in this case, calf muscle contracts, proximal valve opens, and where is the blood going? Toward the heart, right? And that will increase venous return. Okay, now let's go the other way. The woman is no longer standing on her tippy toes, and so the calf muscle relaxes. As a result, the proximal valve closes. But why? Gravity. Gravity pushes blood back down the leg, which pushes the valve shut. So the proximal valve closes, and the distal valve will open. So in this illustration, would this increase or decrease venous return? Decrease. So altering the venous return will alter the central venous pressure. The next factor is the respiratory pump. So take a deep breath, a really big one, come on. What happens to the pressure in your abdomen while you're taking this really deep breath? Did the pressure in your abdomen go up? It increases, right? Okay, when you took that big old deep breath, what happened to the volume of your thoracic cavity? It increased too. And therefore, the pressure in the thoracic cavity decreases. This is due to Boyle's law. Remember that blood moves from a high pressure toward a low pressure. So we have a high pressure in the abdominal area and a low pressure in the thoracic area. What will this do to venous return? It increases, which brings blood back to the heart. The third factor is the blood volume. We begin with increasing your blood volume. All right, so if you have an increasing blood volume, and we'll talk later about how you can increase your blood volume, but if you have a high blood volume, your central venous pressure is going to be higher since there is a greater volume of blood. Then that will increase end-diastolic volume, decrease your end-systolic volume, increase stroke volume and cardiac output, and then increase MAP. Let's switch it around now. Now there is a decreased volume of blood in the vessel. What happens to your central venous pressure? It decreases. Your end-diastolic volume? It decreases. Stroke volume? Decreases. Why does stroke volume decrease? Remember, there's less blood in the ventricle, so less muscle stretch, and if there's not as much stretch, there are fewer cross bridges forming, which decreases the force of contraction and therefore decreases stroke volume. Since stroke volume is decreased, this will cause the end-systolic volume to increase. And if stroke volume goes down or decreases, cardiac output decreases, and MAP decreases as well. The last factor that will affect central venous pressure, and therefore venous return, is what we call venomotor tone. This is defined as the tension that gets created in a blood vessel. In this case, we're going to be talking about veins. Veins can undergo vasoconstriction when the sympathetic nervous system dominates, as this will cause the smooth muscles lining the blood vessels to contract. And that's what causes vasoconstriction. And vasoconstriction increases tension, which is an increased venomotor tone. Okay, so by doing that, now think about where your veins are. What's the role of a vein? Where are they taking blood? Back to the heart, right? So vasoconstriction of a vein will increase central venous pressure, and therefore venous return will push the blood that's in front of the constriction into the heart. This is kind of like kinking a hose. So if your central venous pressure goes up, end diastolic volume goes up, your stroke volume goes up, cardiac output goes up, and MAP goes up. And what happens to end systolic volume? It goes down. All right, so here's a summary of all the factors that we just talked about and how they can affect central venous pressure. Remember, if central venous pressure is altered, this will ultimately alter the mean arterial pressure.